Hello, welcome to RC Video Reviews. Today we're taking a look at the Jumper T-Lite Radio with Express LRS. Before we get started, I need to let you know this video is sponsored by Banggood. I'd like to say thanks to Banggood for sending this unit out for review and to remind you, if you'd like to pick one up for yourself, there'll be a link in the description. It is an affiliate link, so if you don't mind using that, the channel gets a little bit of a referral and it doesn't cost you anything extra. With that out of the way, let's get started. This is the Express LRS version of the T-Lite. They do have a 4-in-1 version. This is also a V2 radio, so not the V1, the V2. And I will only be talking about the Express LRS elements today because that's what I've got in front of me. So regarding the radio, on the outside, you've got this rubberized coating, and I'm kind of jury's out on this one. I'm not sure if I like it or not. It feels good in the hands, but I can imagine on a hot summer day, if your hands are a little bit sweaty, it might feel a little bit slippery. And then the other thing regarding ergonomics is finger placement. I like to put my fingers up on top on these little gamepad radios to kind of hold things. But the problem is those switches are really close, and I kind of have a feeling that any movement, and I might accidentally activate or deactivate one of these switches. So I'm not a big fan of that. I really rather see like some sort of trigger down here at the bottom that keeps my fingers away from those switches. So that's the main thing on ergonomics. The handle is a little bit small for my hands, but you know, if you have smaller hands, maybe it'll work for you. That's really a subjective thing though. I don't really fault the radio, it's just what it is. It's the size of the radio. It's not that I can't get a grip on it. I can get a decent grip on it, but it does feel a little bit small in my hands. Regarding the hardware on the outside, you do have a removable antenna. Remember, because this is removable, make sure you attach that before you turn the transmitter on because you don't want to damage your transmitter. You also have a USB-C port that is there for charging and for connecting to the computer. There's an SD card. Now, the webpage that I read said the SD card was not included, but this one has a 512 meg SD card, and it's got a trainer port and a couple of screws up top for mounting peripherals like, say, an FPV monitor. And then along the top, you've got a couple of switches. You've got SA over here on the left. That is a 3-position switch. SB on the right is also 3-position. And then on the back, you've got SD and SC, but they're only 2-position switches and no momentary switches. Now there is a way to use the trim switches as momentary switches in Edge TX by going into flight modes and turning off trim if you want to do that. But because there are only 4 trims, the only one you can really, for electric flying at least, the only one you can really get rid of is the throttle trim. So just keep that in mind, no momentary switches. For me, I actually put momentary switches to great use, so that's a little bit of a miss for me. Finally, around the backside, there's a single 18650 battery that fits under this cover, and it's easy to replace, you know, take it in and out, no problems there. And then they also include this little adapter to mount nano transmitters on the back of the radio. And I'm going to tell you guys, let's cut to the chase, I don't like it. So you have to connect this little JST pin header onto the back of the radio. And here's what I don't like about it. The back of the radio is flat, and this little converter board or adapter board, it does have little tiny standoffs, but they're simply not enough. You lay it on top of the wiring for your transmitter, and what ends up happening is your transmitter is basically bent at a 90 degree, and when you screw this thing down, it's pressing on those wires, and I don't like it. I think they could have done a little better by making the standoffs on this a little bit taller, or by recessing the cable into the chassis a little bit more, or maybe rounding out or putting a little square hump on the back so that the adapter board could mount flush without pressing on those wires. I just don't like it. I think it's, to me, that's one of the things that has to be improved when it comes to engineering. The last thing I want to do is have a 90 degree bend in my wires and pressure on top of it for something as important as my transmitter. That's just not cool for me. Anyway, on the back, you also have a couple of screws. There's a 3 on each side, so 6 screws to take the back cover off. And that's about it for the external bits on the radio. These are Hall Effect sensor gimbals, and they're full-size gimbals, so I feel like I've got full throw. I don't think if you're a pincher, you're going to want to use this. It probably wouldn't feel all that great to you. It'd probably feel a little awkward, but for thumbers, no problem. That works great if you're a thumber. Originally, I had planned on showing you how to upgrade Edge TX on this radio, but I found out during testing that by updating to the current 2.7.1, it actually breaks communication with Express LRS. So for that reason, I'm not going to show you, but I can tell you that you could flash nightly on here, 2.8, it works. And the way you flash is like any other radio. You press the inboard 2 trim buttons on the bottom, and then you power the radio on. So I'll just show you how to get into bootloader mode real quick. Turn the radio off, press these 2 trim buttons, turn the radio on, And there we go, we're in the bootloader mode. So if you connect your SD card to your computer and copy the current Edge Nightly onto your SD card, you can use the bootloader to flash the firmware for 2.8 Nightly if you want to upgrade. I'm not going to show you how to add a Nightly to the radio because I don't want people coming back and going, well, you told me to flash a Nightly, and then they crash their plane and something bad happens. I just don't want that trouble on my hands. What I will show you how to do is update ExpressLRS. And we'll do that by connecting a USB-C cable to the top port. Remember, there's only one port on this radio, and it's for charging and for connecting to your computer. So you want to plug that in, and you'll be prompted on your screen when you do that for joystick, storage, or serial VCP. And you'll press the page down buttons right here on the right and go to that serial VCP screen. And once you've got that selected, you're going to press the enter key, and that will put the radio in communications with your PC. So USB-C cable to your computer, and there you go. The next thing we'll do is bring up the ExpressLRS configurator. I'll put links in the description for this as well. And great news, ExpressLRS just dropped 3.0, which has support for this radio and the transmitter board inside the radio. So what we'll do is select 3.0 for releases, and under target for device category, we're gonna look for jumper. We're gonna scroll down and look for the jumper 2.4 gigahertz. And for device, we're going to look for the jumper AION T-Lite 2400TX. That's the one we want right there. And for flashing method, we're going to use EdgeTX pass-through. Don't forget to download the Lua script and update it. I've been talking to the developers about this, and they say version 2 Lua is pretty close to 3. There may be a few things, but just make sure you update the Lua script. Download it and install it on the card. You can do that by clicking the link, and you'll see ELRS version 3.lua. And what you want to do is save that in the scripts tools directory on the SD card of the radio. Next up, for regulatory domain, choose the one that suits you the best. In my case, it's ISM 2400. You'd use EU if you're in the EU. For a binding phrase, go ahead and put in a binding phrase that you have on your receivers and choose your other options. I like a Wi-Fi on interval of 20 seconds. I also enter my home Wi-Fi SSID and password so the transmitter can connect to my home network and I can upgrade the firmware over the wireless network in my house. Finally, under actions, there's a drop-down list and you want to select the COM port that your computer picked when you connected the radio to the computer. I often get asked questions about solving USB driver-related issues on Windows and Linux, and guys, I simply cannot be in that business because there's a myriad of different things that could be at play. I just simply can't be in the business of supporting USB issues you might be having. What I will tell you are there are two phrases you want to be familiar with when it comes to drivers for these radios on your computer. The first one is STM Electronics. If you Google STM Electronics, you'll find a link where you can download drivers for STM Electronics dongles. You can see in this case, it's COM3 and the driver being used is STM Microelectronics. The other phrase you want to be familiar with is ZADIG. If you go out and Google ZADIG, you can replace Windows USB drivers with the correct drivers, and sometimes that'll solve your issues as well. In my case, my computer correctly identified the COM port and the driver to use, and that's COM3. Next thing I'll do is hit build and flash. Okay, once you see this writing at and the percentages go by, that's a pretty good indication that you're writing to the firmware to the transmitter, and you should be good to go once this process is complete. Okay, with that done, we now see jumper AION 2400 success. That's all you need. We can close this out. Okay, with our flash complete, the next thing we'll do is disconnect the USB cable from the radio. And then I do like to power it down, so press the power button, shut it down, and then turn the radio back on. Then the next thing I'll do is bring in an ExpressLRS receiver, and I've got a little Maytek PWM receiver. I'll connect a battery to the ESC, and we should get a bind pretty quick. There we go, solid light. Now regarding ExpressLRS capabilities, let's go ahead and press the system button, and then we'll go into the ExpressLRS Lua by pressing enter, and we'll take a look at the options in ExpressLRS. For packet rate, we can go all the way up to 1000, so I'll hit enter, and then I'm gonna hit down and scroll through the options. So there's D500, F500, and F1000. So we'll go back down, and I'm gonna go ahead and set this on 333 because that's the one I use for PWM. And then I'll hit return, and for power, I wanted to show you the dynamic power real quick and what the options are there. I'll press enter, and when I click enter again on a dynamic power value, I hit page left, and we can go all the way down to 10 milliwatts is what I'm seeing there. And then if I hit page down, we go back up and it goes as high as 100. I think I read in the original documentation 25 and 150, but I'm seeing 10 and 100. That's what I see using Express LRS 3.0. And then finally, I'll just move the stick to show you that we've got PWM output to a servo via Express LRS, so we're all set. Everything looks good. Overall, I think this is a decent little radio, especially if you like this small form factor. I'm a little kind of 50-50 on the rubberized texture. I mean, it feels smooth, but I'm not sure outside in the heat with the sun and sweat if it's going to feel slippery or not. Just not sure about that. Jury's out on that one. I think the big miss for me is a lack of any momentary switch at all, which means you have to use software tricks to maybe convert one of your trim switches to a momentary. The gimbals feel fine. They are Hall Effect gimbals, and they're pretty much par for the course on these smaller radios. It's about what I would expect. You do have the ability, if you take the back cover off, to adjust tension if you want to. You can do that. The screen is a little bit on the small side, especially compared to other options out there like the Zorro, which has a little bit of a bigger screen. So a little bit small, but it is effective. For me, on these small form factor radios anyway, I normally do my configuration in Companion. So I don't worry too much about it on the radio. I just use the radio to select models. I really don't do much configuration work when I have a real small screen like this. The detachable antenna is good, and the Express LRS capabilities with the built-in VCP connection for flashing, they all work just fine. That wraps up my first look at the Jumper T-Lite V2 with Express LRS. I'd like to say thanks again to Banggood for sending this unit out for review. I remind you, if you'd like to pick one up, I've got an affiliate link in the description for you to use. If you like this kind of material, make sure you subscribe and hit that notification bell so you know new videos hit the channel. That's all I've got for today. Take it easy and go fly something. Hey, if you like the work I do here on RC Video Reviews, please consider joining me on Patreon. For about the price of a cup of coffee, you can help me keep making videos just like this one. If you'd like to help out, there's a link in the description and on your screen.